Howdy everyone, Shamai Palp, and today I'm testing out another of Fuji's very nice XF lenses, the XF 16-55mm f2.8 RLMWR. It's only for their X series mirrorless cameras, and it comes in at a very pricey £900 in the UK or $1,000 US, although Fuji often offer cashback deals on it. A fast aperture standard zoom lens is considered to be an essential option in the lineup of any camera system, especially to professional photographers, and this is Fuji's offering. It's the full frame equivalent of 24-85mm, a really nice standard zoom range, with the full frame equivalent depth of field of f4.5 or so, so it can give you somewhat out of focus backgrounds too. However, although a lot of reviews out there have found it to be a very sharp lens, it'd be fair to say that the critical reaction to it has been slightly muted, mostly due to its very large size, huge price, and disappointing lack of image stabilization. I really missed image stabilization on this lens, especially after using the much smaller XF 18-55mm f2.8-f4 OIS lens for so long. This more expensive, constant aperture f2.8 option is clearly aimed at professional photojournalists or wedding photographers perhaps, who don't really care about size or price, and who are taking pictures of people with shutter speeds fast enough not to need image stabilization so much. Still, I do wish it was stabilized, but not everyone values that as highly as I do. Its build quality is what I've come to expect from one of Fuji's XF lenses, a tightly assembled construction of metal and high quality plastics, and this one has lots of weather sealing too. As I've mentioned, it's pretty large and a little heavy, weighing in at 650 grams. The aperture ring works nicely, with just the right amount of positive clicks. The zoom ring doesn't turn quite as smoothly as I was hoping. It's not bad, but it does tick slightly, so that was a disappointment after testing the XF 18-55mm lens. And the focus ring, as usual nowadays, works electronically by wire, and it responds quickly and precisely. Here you can see the autofocus at work in video mode. In stills mode, it's about twice as fast as this, super quick actually, and nice and accurate. And as you can see here, this lens does not struggle with focus breathing. The image doesn't zoom in or out as you change focus. The lens has a 77mm filter thread, and it comes with an appropriately sized hood. Overall, the build quality is fine, and the autofocus especially fast, but the incredibly solid quality you get with the older XF 18-55mm lens isn't quite there, unfortunately. So let's see about this lens's fabled sharpness by testing it on a 24-megapixel Fuji X-T20. Inner camera corrections are turned on. At 16mm and f2.8, the lens is brilliantly sharp in the middle of the image with great contrast. Over in the corners, we see very good sharpness, although noticeably less punchy than the middle. At f4, those corners are just a whisker sharper, f5.6 is a touch sharper again. The corners stay this sharp down to f11, where a little softness is creeping in due to the effects of diffraction. So it's a pretty good start at 16mm. Let's zoom in now a bit to 30mm. It's the same story, really. At f2.8, the middle of the image is just as fantastic as it was at 16mm, and the corners look similarly good, and it stays about as sharp down to f8. Again, really quite impressive. Finally, let's zoom all the way in to 55mm. At f2.8, again, the middle looks really fantastic, sharp with great contrast. Over in the corners, we finally see a hiccup. They look a bit weak here. F4 is the same, but stop down to f5.6 for a nice jump in resolution, and f8 looks brilliant. So overall, it's clear that this lens offers a generally impressive performance, but that Fuji's engineers chose to favour corner image quality at wider angles. Makes sense really, bright apertures at 55mm are ideal for portrait photography, where corner image quality isn't so important, because often you're out of focus anyway. Alright, vignetting and distortion. This is normally corrected in your camera or automatically in Fuji's RAW conversion software, whether you like it or not, but some third-party editing programs let you see the real picture. At 16mm, those in-camera corrections are hiding some very strong barrel distortion, much worse than usual for a zoom lens, and at f2.8 we see some pretty noticeable vignetting. Stopping down to f4 will bring it under control though. In the middle of the zoom range, the distortion straightens out, as you'd expect, and vignetting is a lot tamer, but zoom in all the way to 55mm to enjoy some pretty heavy pincushion distortion now, and vignetting is back at f2.8. Stop down to f4 for brighter corners, so the lens is clearly under-designed here. Now, let's see about close-up image quality. The lens can focus down to about 40cm when zoomed right in. At f2.8, close-up image quality is a bit soft. You only need to stop down to f4 though for a dramatic improvement. Next, let's see how this lens works against bright lights. Whatever lens coatings Fuji are using, they're clearly doing their job. Flaring is minimal, contrast remains high, whether zoomed out or zoomed in. Good job, Fuji. Finally, bokeh. This lens doesn't actually give you the most out-of-focus backgrounds in the world, really, and when it does, they just look average, slightly nervous around the edges. Overall, the XF 16-55mm f2.8 has a lot going for it, nice build quality and plenty of sharpness and contrast. I think some professionals will be quite satisfied, but I wasn't a fan of it myself. Here it is compared to the older XF 18-55mm. The 16-55 gives you a brighter aperture, but only when you're zoomed in. It's also a little sharper, and its widest angle a little wider, but the 18-55mm lens's list of advantages really tick all my own boxes. I hate to keep banging this drum, but when I was out shooting I just found it really hard to get over the lack of stabilisation on the 16-55 lens. Not everyone will be bothered by this, I know, but I sure was. I'd say that 90% of Fuji shooters out there watching this video will actually be much happier with the lovely little 18-55mm lens instead.